next.
Good morning. For today's admission rounds from pediatric nephrology units, we'll see an overview on vascular access for hemodialysis in CKD children and the care of AV fistula. A 6-year-old girl resident of Chandigarh presented on January 2018 with the complaints of not gaining weight and height. As evaluated on OPD basis in a private hospital, found to had a bilateral small kidneys and referred to PGA. And there was no history of previous hematuria or UTI, there was no history of decreased urine output or polyuria, and no history of headache and seizures, and there was no history of significant pallor. And post history was not significant, and child is first born of a non-consanguineous marriage with no history of similar complaints in the sibling or any renal disorders in the family members. Birth history and developmental history was normal and immunized as per national immunization program, and caloric intake and protein intake are adequate. On examination, weight was 15 kg and height was 108 cm, both less than 2 Z-score, and BP was more than 99th centile. On general examination, there was no pallor, icterus, clubbing, edema or lymphadenopathy, no history of pigmentary patches, no dysmorphic features, no congenital anomalies, hair, nail and oral cavity was normal, abdomen was soft, tender, soft, not tender, no organomegaly, and other systems are within normal limits. On a database, we have a 6-year-old girl, first born of non-consanguineous couple, developmentally normal, immunized for age, and outside ultrasound suggestive of bilateral small kidneys. On examination, had a stunting, wasting, and hypertension. And further investigation, hemogram and iron profile was normal, had a elevated urea creatinine, and evidence of mineral bone disease, and metabolic acidosis. And ultrasonograms has confirmed a right kidney of 5.2 cm and left kidney of 5.4 cm with accentuated corticomedullary differentiation, APD and ureter and urinary bladder was normal. Micturating cysteroerythrogram was done to rule out a reflux disease was normal. The final diagnosis of stage 4 CKD with the mineral bone disease, metabolic acidosis and growth failure, and etiology of CAC would possibly a renal hypoplasia. The child was initially started on conservative management, followed up on renal clinic and renal transplant OPD. Parents were counseled for hemodialysis and renal transplant. And AV fistula was created on June 2018 and child is dialysis dependent since December 2018. And dialysis will be initiated when one or more of the following conditions. The symptoms are signs attributable to kidney failures like serositis, acid-base or electrolyte abnormalities and pruritus, inability to control the volume status or blood pressure, progressive deterioration of nutritional status refractory to dietary intervention, and cognitive impairment. This often occurs in a GFR range between 5 to 10 ml per minute per meter square. And renal transplantation is the treatment of choice in end-stage renal disease. While awaiting transplantation, it is bridged by hemodialysis or chronic peritoneal dialysis. Regarding hemodialysis with peritoneal dialysis, hemodialysis is highly efficient in solute clearance. However, it needs a vascular access and it is possible to use in a hemodynamically unstable patient. And peritoneal dialysis has low efficient in solute clearance and has a better ultrafiltration control, and it is a complex procedure. For a good vascular access is crucial for the success of the dialysis. It can be done through a central venous catheter, which is the most common vascular access in pediatric hemodialysis patient, and arteriovenous fistula, which is the best form of access, are done by shunt or graft, which is rarely used. As the venous catheter is of two types, it is used temporary double lumen catheter for a short-term dialysis, or a tunneled cuffed catheter, which is surgically placed in a subcutaneous plane, placed in an IJV or a subclavian vein, can be used for a chronic dialysis over a period of 6 months to 1 year, however carry a risk of infection, thrombosis and stenosis. Another form of access is an AV graft, which is done by surgically anastomosing artery with the vein through artificial graft like polytetraethylene or a Teflon. It matures fastest within 1 to 3 weeks, and complication like infection, stenosis and thrombosis is high in this. And the most preferred vascular access for hemodialysis is arteriovenous fistula, which is created by surgically anastomosing artery to the vein, preferred in a non-dominant arm. in a forearm veins. The pre-assessment includes the ultrasonography and of a arterial and venous system of the arm to assess the size of the vessels, and usually the maturation times is 6 to 12 weeks, and maturity will be assessed by palpating for a thrill or listening to the bruit. Maturity can be, hand exercise is advised to again a quick maturity. And arterial venous fistula is created by anastomoting the artery to the vein. It can be done at a wrist by anastomoting a radial artery with a cephalic vein, or at a elbow with a brachial artery with a cephalic vein, or at a arm with a basilic vein with a brachial artery. It is preferred to start distally, and larger the vessel, there is a greater chance of the success. Coming to the examination of the AV fistula, in inspection, we should look for the general development of the child and look for evidence of aneurysm and skin colors of the extremities or any swelling or signs of infection or ischemic spots in the fingertips. On palpation, normally the pulses in an AV fistula, the pulse is soft and compressible. However, in a stenosis, which is in the outflow side, there is a high degree of hyperpulsatility, which is proportional to the severity of the stenosis. If the stenosis on the inflow side, there is usually a weak pulse, which is not get augmented by a pulse augmentation test. And for palpation, normally the thrill is soft, continuous, which has a both systolic and diastolic component. However, in a stenotic lesion, it is strong, it is localized, and it is strong, it is increased and have only a systolic component. Similarly, in the bruit, where on auscultation, normal situation, the bruit is low pitched and have a both systolic and diastolic components. However, in a stenotic lesion, we will be able to hear only a systolic component, and it is high pitched. On summarizing the examination, clinical examination of an AV fistula, in an inflow stenosis, we will have a hypopulsatile fistula with a poor pulse augmentation, and the thrill and bruit is usually discontinuous and decreased. On outflow stenosis, while we are raising the arm and the arm of the arm, the fistula does not collapse, and it became hyperpulsatile on palpation, and the bruit and thrill is discontinuous and increased at the site of the lesion. In a case of central venous stenosis, the ipsilateral arm or contralateral bilateral arm swelling may be present, and collateral veins will be visible and does not collapse with the arm elevation. In general fistula care, we should avoid sampling and BP measurement or sleeping on the arm of the fistula, upper limb of the fistula. The patients are to be instructed and to keep the area clean, not to wear any jewelry or apply pressure, sterile precaution to be used during the initiation of the hemodialysis, proper cannulation and decannulation of fistula should be done during every cycle of hemodialysis. The most common complication of the fistula is thrombosis, stenosis, or congestive heart failure, or ischemic neuropathy, or ischemic steel syndrome, or aneurysm, or infection. This is a representational picture of ulceration and pseudoaneurysm and ischemia in the fingertips. In the index case, the child went through the maintenance hemodialysis through AV fistula for a few months and fortunate enough to receive a renal transplant few days back. The donor was a mother. And AV fistula, take home message is the AV fistula is most effective assess for the hemodialysis. Proper care and maintenance of the fistula is very important for effective dialysis. Thank you.